American Cruise, so I'm excited to see how this one plays out.
Yep, you can see the Betway odds favoring Isurus so far. They are starting on the CT side. And you've got a bit of a push. A beautiful pop flash. That looks absolutely anti-stratted, but Bluemeister holds his ground, is able to turn 2-for-1. After being completely flashed, Isurus struggled with getting that totem pole stacked down. Now Riverseed comes from the backside. Bluemeister is absolutely distraught against Isurus. He's just managing to stop every push. Now they're getting caught out of...
What was Sickly's choice there? I guess he didn't want to pick up a Galil in the fray of things, wanted to go for full utility, just preferred a CC. But it will be Noxy taking down Link. If Meyer takes down Blue, this is mid-fight. It's not going the way Denial expected.
Well, this is what I was saying at the beginning. Denial kept running into mid very, very rapidly at the beginnings of their rounds. And I was thinking Isurus probably wouldn't want to challenge that directly, but maybe they do want to do that. They've been sending the AUG and an AWP to the top right there and able to support one another. You can still see the little crossfire setup they have. Vati came up through and is trying to catch the AWPer that was running around towards the lane. Instead, he's broadsided from the left flank. Sickly is last man standing, and these rounds are playing out relatively quickly because they're getting an AWP, and they're just ready to pop off on a couple players. The auger is holding on to the right side, being able to spray down to the left towards alt mid in case that the riflers are able to get up to that position. But this is going to be another eco round. Should be more or less the same. Isurus are continue to just rack up rounds. They'll end up on their sixth likely. So here's the T's make their way up in towards the A site. But Banana's been pushed. It's going to be even more so. Myron gets all the way down to the logs and then falls back. So they seem to do these little push pokes and prods onto Denial. Gets them a little flustered. They might hear some audio cues. Even in rifle rounds, we've seen that out there as well. So Denial are probably feeling a little unsettled right now, that they aren't able to set up their own strategies. They keep getting Isurus coming in here and just throwing a wrench in the spokes.
Well, that's the thing about CT early on, but Isurus going very fast into B should be taking this uncontested.
They are giving Denial absolutely no quarter. There's going to be a triple stack through Graffiti, and they're actually going to pick up a kill from that as well. There is a rifle that can be recovered, and I was thinking some of these angles were going to be difficult to recover rifles from. Good grenade in, but if you got a gun that's down in short, that's much easier to recover than a gun that's down in sight somewhere.
How are they going to get to it, though? This crossfire from Isurus just holding down short as 1962 taking down three members towards that post plan, and Isurus off to a
piece of utility we actually haven't seen yet, I don't believe, is the Molotov that was where the top of the T-ramp is. Denial just threw a smoke into that position, but Isurus are going to say thank you, says thank you very much, 1962. The one tap against the jumping Vati, and now the B-site looks even
He's
more tempting.
Keep going.
They said 1962 was such a good entry frag.